This is Dana again with another tutorial. I'm here with Creatively Created Crochet. Today we will be making some awesome cup cozies. As you can see, I made a few here. I haven't sewn my buttons on yet, but this is just what it would look like if I was to put a button on. This is made with an acrylic yarn. This is actually made with Red Heart Super Saver Ombre in the color of True Blue. Now this is made with a cotton yarn, and this cotton yarn is from Peaches and Cream, and it's the color gray, and I put a white button on it. I like the way it looks. I probably will sew it on just as soon as I get done with this tutorial. There's another one I made, guys. This yarn is Scarfy by Lion Brand. Now this yarn is acrylic, but it also has wool in it, so it really does a trick when it comes to these cup cozies, guys. Now, when it comes to cup cozies, you can make them any size, any length, or any size or width that you would like. But I do have a shorter cup cozy, a shorter cup, guys. So I didn't make mine extremely long or extremely tall because I did want to use it to actually put on my cup and use it as a sleeve. Just like so, guys. And this will help me not to burn my hands if my coffee is extremely hot. Now, this is a season where we'll be drinking more coffee. We'll also probably let our children drink hot chocolate. We'll probably drink hot chocolate on days when it's chilly. So I figured this would be a great tutorial. Now, this is beginner friendly, but I will be doing some more intermediate tutorials soon. I just wanted to do my first one as a just something beginner friendly, and also something that you can do as an intermediate, because this is the type of thing that people will buy, and also that you can buy yourselves, or you can make for gifts as well. So to get started, I'm gonna go ahead and show you what we need. I got some size 4 worsted weight yarn. This is Red Heart Super Saver. It's acrylic. I also have a size 5.5 millimeter hook. I have a pair of scissors for snipping when I'm done with my work. And I also have a yarn needle. Remember what I talked about in my past videos. Keep this yarn needle handy along with your scissors because you will need them. Now, in my previous videos, I showed you how to do chains. I showed you how to do a single crochet. And I also showed you how to do a half double crochet. So with this video, I will not be showing you each step in detail because I have videos with that on there already. So if you definitely need a refresher course, I would recommend you go ahead and watch those videos now. All right, we're going to do a chain of 28. Now, in my previous videos, guys, we chained 10 chains. 4. Now we have our 28 chains, guys. One thing I did not show you in my previous videos was how to slip stitch your work together to join. Now, when you're doing a slip stitch, guys, you have to remember not to twist your chain. An easy way that I do that is I follow my thumb all the way down my chain, making sure I keep it flat as possible, making sure I do not twist it. Now, as I get to the end, I find myself with the back of my chain showing. And what I do is I just insert my hook into the last hump of the chain. And then after I do that, I'm just simply going to wrap my yarn around and insert it and draw through both loops. And that's just it, guys. Very, very simple. And again, like we talked about before in my previous videos, guys, what all I did was go through the humps of each chain, right in the back of that chain. I'm just going to go through each hump, guys. So to start off, guys, I'm just going to do a chain one, and I'm going to begin to half double. If you remember what a half double is, guys, it's super simple. You're just going to wrap around or yarn over, insert into your hook, into your loop, yarn over again, draw through one, yarn over, and draw through all three. Now that's the half double. And you're just going to do that all the way around, guys. And when you're done, guys, you should have a total of 28 stitches, 28 half double crochets. This is a very super simple tutorial, a very super easy project. These are really cute for Christmas gifts or stocking stuffers. So you can make them in all colors, different types of yarn. As I showed you before, there are different types of yarn you can do and you can use. I'll meet you right back here when I'm finished with this row. All right, guys, I am approaching the very end of my round. And so I'm going to go ahead and insert my hook into the last stitch. Yarning over, pulling through one, yarning over, pulling through all three. Now, I have to make sure before I join again that my round is not twisted. I have to go around just to make sure it lays flat and it's even and there are no twists. Once I have that set right, guys, I'm just going to join. And when I join, I'm going to insert my hook into that first stitch. The first stitch looks like a braid, guys. Remember, let me get that out of your way, guys. And let me show you a little bit what I mean. So I'm going to go ahead and insert it. And do another slip stitch. Now the slip stitch is just inserting, yarning over, and drawing through both loops. All right, guys, just like that. And now we're gonna go ahead and continue with the next round. I'm gonna just go ahead and chain one and half double in each stitch around. Sorry if I'm moving a little fast, guys. It's just a really super easy stitch. Like I mentioned before, it's my favorite because I can whip something up really quick with it. And it's really simple. And it's just really the best stitch in my eyes. I don't have to yarn over a ton of times. I don't have to draw through a ton of times. It's not extremely small or short, and I don't have to. I can make a blanket with it if I want. I can make whatever I like. And I want to also tell you guys, thank you for subscribing to my channel. Thank you for liking my videos. I really appreciate every bit of support, guys. Like I told you guys before, when I hit the 500 subscriber mark, I will definitely be doing some drawings and some giveaways. I'm super excited. And if you guys have any thoughts on what I can make next, please let me know because I would love to see what you guys have ideas for me. I'm almost done with my second round, guys. And for these other ones that I made, I have done a total of 8 rows, guys. Now you can do more or you can do less. It really depends on your cup. If you're working for a taller cup, you may want to do something a little taller. If you're doing a shorter cup, maybe something smaller, but I usually like to work with something that is at least the size of the palm of my hand to ensure that when I grab my cup, my hand will not get burned. My hand is going to be fully protected. So I definitely like to do a minimum of my 8 rows or 8 rounds, guys. All right, guys. So we're finishing up this second row. As we come to the end, guys, we have to remember that we're going to slip stitch in the first chain of the first stitch. Now remember, this is our first stitch, guys. The first braid is our first stitch. So we're just going to insert our hook and we're going to draw through, yarn over, I'm sorry guys, yarn over and draw through both loops. And there goes our end of our second row. So now we have a total of two rounds. And like I told you guys before, I think it's best to do 8 rounds to make sure that your hand is fully protected, just like I've done here. If you do something that is not, it's a little shorter, it will not guarantee that your hand will be fully protected, and you do not want to suffer with burns or, you know, any issues like that. So I'll be back when this is finished, guys. Now hang in there, and I hope that you're following along, and be back soon. All right, guys, so I have finished my cup cozy. And now all there's left to do is to fasten off. And when I fasten off, let me just show you what I usually do. Is I usually just chain one, and I'll pull it through to how long I want it. I don't make it too long, but I make it long enough to weave it in. But I don't make it long enough to where I'm wasting my yarn. So I'm just going to pull it through like so. And I'm going to tighten it, give it a good pull. And I'm going to thread my yarn needle. I don't need my hook anymore. So what I'll do is I'll usually just turn it inside out because I don't want to weave in any of my ends on the right side. I don't want anyone to see where I'm weaving my ends in at. So I'm just basically going to weave it in back and forth. I'd like to do a back and forth pattern to ensure that my ends will stay woven in really nicely. Now again, guys, this is a really awesome pattern. A very easy pattern. You can make this with scrap yarn if you don't really want to open up a fresh skein, and it takes no time. Now, these are a couple pictures I'm showing right here of some that I made, and I just created characters with them. Those are really great for kids. All you have to do is add different faces to them. Very simple, guys. If you want me to help you with that or to give you some tips on how you can create those, let me know in the comments. I definitely can. And these are some pictures of some that I've created with my own pattern, which you can also purchase on Ravelry if you're interested. They're really nice patterns. They're not expensive, but they are really cute and really stylish. They offer a little bit more of an intermediate crocheter. I would not say purchase them if you are a beginner, unless you are actually going to start to branch out into becoming an intermediate crocheter. If you're going to become intermediate, I would definitely say go ahead and purchase them. I would never tell you not to, but I just want to make sure that it will be able to be, you can able, you'll be able to understand it. And if you can't understand them, guys, remember that you can always send me a message. I'm on Instagram. I'm on YouTube. I'm on Facebook. So you can always remember to message me. Now, guys, I've woven in both ends. I had an end at the top and an end at the bottom. And now I'm just going to go ahead and snip. Being careful not to snip my actual stitches, guys. Same thing on this one. I'm finished with that, guys. I'm going to turn it back on the right side. It looks really great. Again, you can add your buttons if you want to add a button. It could be here in the middle. It could be a bigger button, a smaller button. It could be a gem. It could be a face. It could be anything you want. The choice is yours, guys. So thanks again for watching this video. Remember to like and to share. Remember to subscribe as well. I appreciate you guys. Let's get onto this road to 500 subscribers so we can do our first giveaway. Thanks again for watching, guys. And until we meet again, blessings. Love ya.